Hi, this is Fran with Little Windows Brilliant Resin. I'm going to show you how to add resin to your fabric scraps so you can make jewelry, buttons, beads, all kinds of fun embellishments. For these projects, you'll need fabrics, and you can use any kind and color you have. You'll need Little Windows Brilliant Resin, your mixing cup and mixing wands, some paper towels for cleanup, some small sharp scissors, and a doming tray. We'll be using the silicone version that's large and gives us a great workspace. You'll also need a timer and some wax paper. Depending on the project you're making, you may or may not need to drill through your piece. So the mini hand drill or the creative power drill from littlewindows.com are great tools for that. And then any findings that you need to complete your projects. Before you can dome your fabric pieces on the doming tray, you need to stiffen them, because otherwise when you put the resin on, it's just going to bleed right through and it's not going to give you a stable base to support that resin and dome up nicely. So what you need to do first is stiffen them, and we're going to do that by adding a layer of resin to each piece. To stiffen your fabrics doesn't take a lot of resin, so we'll mix up one standard batch, which is about a tablespoon. 10 milliliters of part A, and 5 milliliters of part B. Set your timer for 2.5 minutes and stir slowly, mixing the resin thoroughly from top to bottom. I've stirred this for 2.5 minutes, and now we need to let it rest in the cup so that it can continue to blend and any air bubbles I've mixed in can rise to the top. Our resin has been resting for 5 minutes and it's ready to apply to the fabric. So make a little spout with your mixing cup and pour a little bit of resin onto the first project. The resin will go really far because all you're doing is spreading a very thin layer across the material. You want it to be fully coated so that it will be nice and stiff when the resin sets up, but you don't want it too thick because if it's very thick, it'll be difficult for you to cut through with your scissors. So you saw I just used a very small amount and I'm spreading it around on here, kind of like butter. If there's a specific area that you want to make sure to cover, just pull some resin over there to make sure that you get all of the detail that you'd like. You don't have to go all the way to the edge, only if you're going to use that piece in your projects. So I have a nice thin layer. You want to kind of look across, make sure there's no shiny puddles of resin. If you do see that, you can always scoop those up and move on to the next piece. If you have a piece that's curling or that starts to curl while you're putting the resin on, you can, after you've put the resin, you can always just put a new piece of wax paper on top and weigh it down so that it dries flat. This one, though, should flatten out once we've got the resin on it. And this one I'm going to go right off the edge. It doesn't really matter. It is good to be conservative with your resin so that there's no waste. And this one, though, I'm going to use the resin. Pull it to the edge so that it helps the piece lie flat. For this piece, I'm going to be using the center bird and then some of these branches, so I don't need to go all the way to the edge. Just sort of put it in the area that you're interested in and then spread it around. And you can see on this particular one that the fabric changes pretty significantly with the resin. The way that you can test this before putting the resin on is to just put a small piece of the fabric into water. And whatever happens in the water, the same effect will happen when the resin is put on. So some of them go very dark, other ones hardly change color at all. You can see I covered quite a bit of fabric, and I still have plenty of resin left over from that single batch. So make sure that you plan accordingly, because once you have this mixed, you will need to use up the part that's blended. There's another way to stiffen your fabrics, and that's by using a white, thick, heavy paper. You can use cardstock or a scrapbook paper or even a scrap of photopaper to do this. And what we're going to do is mount the fabric on top of that white paper. And it not only stabilizes it, but it also enhances the color, because by having that white background behind, the color of the fabric itself and also some of the texture is going to show a little bit more. So the way you do that is with our double stick adhesive that you can find at little-windows.com. You're just going to peel the sheet and apply it to your white paper. And I'm going to do the whole sheet here, but you can also cut small portions if you prefer. So you just rub that on to make sure that it is stuck down nicely, and then peel off the backer sheet. This adhesive is great because it's very strong, but it's also very, very thin. And you just arrange your cutout fabric pieces onto that adhesive. So try to make the best use of the space. I'm going to fit this little guy right in here. Make sure that these are rubbed down. And then you can cut these pieces out and they'll already have the stiffened back so that you can dome straight onto them. I've done the same thing with my kitty fabric. Just cut out some different shapes and mounted them with the double stick adhesive onto the cardstock. It's been 12 hours, so the resin has set up and we've peeled our fabric swatches off of the wax paper. And you can see it creates kind of a piece that now feels like paper itself. It's very textured. It's got some flexibility to it, but you can see that it's now waterproof with that layer of resin on it. So it's ready to cut. There are several ways that you can go about doing this. In the example that we showed, there are some where we're using very fine detail to cut intricate shapes out. And you can do that either with your scissors for the outside, and then come back with an X-Acto knife and cut out any inside pieces that are too detailed to get to with your scissors. Or you can cut out simple shapes like we did for the charms and just cut these any way you like. You can cut right up to the color, or you can leave a border around, whatever appeals to you. You can cut your pieces as large or small as you like. Make sure they're very flat before you put them on the doming tray. Otherwise, the resin can bleed off the edges. If your layer of resin is thin enough, you can also use sharp paper punches to create shapes. And those can make beautiful pendants and buttons and accents. So we have our pieces arranged on the board. Some of these we've stiffened with resin, other ones we've stiffened with the paper behind that, and we'll dome them all together. I've already mixed up my batch of resin and let it rest for 5 minutes, so now we're ready to pour this on. If you've got any regular shapes, like the one that we punched out, you can simply pour a puddle of the resin in the center, and that will flow to the edges. But for any of these that have more intricate shapes, you're going to want to apply the resin using your mixing wand. So it takes a little bit more time, but it will prevent the resin from overflowing. So pour a little resin in the center of each of the main shapes, and then use your mixing wand to pull it down into the little detailed pieces. When you put the resin on the fabric, you'll notice that it doesn't flow as smoothly as it does on paper. That's because of the texture of the fabric, so you'll need to sort of pull it along where you'd like it to be using your mixing wand. And for that reason, you want your pieces spaced a little further apart so that in case they scooch around on the board, they're not going to stick to one another. And the silicone doming tray is especially nice for very small pieces as well, because they can balance on the little points, which are spaced quite close together. You can also hold onto a portion of your piece while you're putting the resin on. This is a large enough shape. I can start by just pouring from my mixing cup directly onto the shape itself, and then I can come back in with my mixing wand and spread that around where I need it to be. Make sure when you cut out your shapes that you don't leave any sharp points. For example, we rounded that beak a little bit because once the resin gets on there, that could be quite sharp. And the resin will flow and self-level. So we've domed all of these. I was a little short on resin, so this one I'll do in my next batch, but you might need to make sure that you cover your projects while they're setting up so that no dust will settle on the surface. Here are some pieces that are already set up, and they are ready to flip over and dome the back sides. If you happen to have any fabric fibers sticking out, you can simply trim those off with your scissors to make it nice and smooth before you dome the other side. So we're going to flip these all over. Sometimes when you're pouring the resin with the doming technique, you'll have some that pours over from the front to the back. And the reason it did it on this one is because I made a very sharp point here where the little kitty's legs are together. If I had rounded that, the resin would not have been pulled to the back side. But it's still going to be just fine. What I can do is just trim that little overflow piece off, make it as flat as I can, and then when I dome that up, it's just going to seal right into that. I notice there's a little bit of overflow on this fabric piece as well. So I can do the same thing and just trim that off with my scissors just to make it flat close to the edge there because I don't want a big lump. There we go. And that's ready to dome. Once you've domed both sides of your fabric piece, it'll have this beautiful glossy look. And this can be turned into whatever you'd like. If you wanted to make a pendant, you would drill a hole. If you wanted to make a button, you can put two or four holes right through that, and that would be a beautiful accent. You can also make necklaces and pins and all kinds of fun things with these pieces. This one, you'll see we've added a few little flakes of our dichroish film, which really adds a nice touch. But you can embellish any way you like. Now that you've resined your fabrics, you can make all kinds of projects. Jewelry, like necklaces, charms, and pins. Or embellishments, like stickers, where you'll add double stick adhesive to the back of your pieces. You can make magnets, buttons, zipper pulls, whatever you want. For more fun ways to create with resin, and the best products to use, go to little-windows.com.